I am the good shepherd.
I am the
good shepherd gives his life for the sheep.
I am the good shepherd.
Yeah.
The good shepherd lays his life down for the sheep. Verse 15. Verse 14.
I am the good shepherd.
I am the good shepherd.
And I know my sheep.
And I know my sheep.
And I am known
and
by my
I
own.
Am known by my sheep. I am the good shepherd.
Yeah.
I lay down my life
yeah.
for my sheep.
Yeah.
I am the good shepherd.
Yeah.
I know my sheep and they know me. Mm. Verse 27.
My sheep hear my voice.
My sheep hear
my voice.
My sheep, the instrument,
yeah.
hear my voice.
Yes, and I know them.
And I know them.
And they follow me.
And they follow me.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Verse 2 to 5.
Yeah. Yeah. Of chapter 10.
Chapter 10.
Mm. Verse 2.
Verse 2.
But he who enters.
He who enters.
By the door is,
by
the,
shepherd
door
is the shepherd of the sheep.
To him the doorkeeper opens.
The doorkeeper or the porter opens.
And the sheep hear his voice.
The sheep hear his voice.
And he calls his own sheep
and
by
he
name.
He calls his own sheep by name.
And leads them
not
out.
By name, by name.
By name.
Yes.
And he leads
and
them out.
And he leads them out.
Verse 4.
Verse 4.
And when he brings out his own
when
sheep.
When he brings out his own sheep.
He goes before them.
He goes not behind but
before them.
Yes.
And the sheep follow
and the sheep follow not lead.
For
him.
They know.
For
his
they
voice.
Know. His, they are following because
they
know his voice.
Amen. That's right.
5.
Yet they will by no means follow
a stranger.
Mm-hmm.
A stranger, they will never follow. Nada, particular case. They will never follow a stranger. Why? Because they
will flee from him.
They will flee from the stranger because
but
they know.
So they do not know the voice.
His voice. They do not know the voice of the stranger.
Amen.
The book of John.
Yeah.
That's my favorite book.
Amen.
It was written by
Amen.
John the Beloved.
Amen.
He was one of Jesus' disciples.
Amen.
He was once a son of thunder.
Amen.
Who became an end product of love.
Amen.
When he writes, he is the writer who writes about love.
Amen.
First, second, third John.
Amen.
He is writing about love.
Amen.
Oh, what manner of love
Amen.
That the Father has lavished upon us. That we should be called
Son.
The children, the sons of God. That's John, the beloved. He wrote the gospel according to John. First and second and third John. Then he is also the writer
Amen.
Of the book of Revelation.
Amen.
When he wrote this book, John the beloved.
Amen.
Do you remember this person who says, I was once on the Isle of Patmos? Meaning when he wrote that book,
Amen.
He was no longer on the Isle of Patmos.
Yeah.
He was an elder at Ephesus. That's the CV. That's John CV.
Amen.
John the beloved, when he wrote the book of John, he was the last of Jesus' disciples to live upon planet Earth. All the others have been beheaded. They had died. And he's the only person who died a natural death. That's John, the beloved, one of Jesus' disciples. So when he wrote this book, mind you, he was the last person to live after all the others had died. So when he wrote this book, they were, to those who have attended a church board, they know of matters arising. There were matters arising that pushed John to write this gospel according to John. Now, the matters arising. Point number one, why did he write the book of John? He wrote the book of John because, you see, there was some waning piety. People were, because of the persecution that was, you know, that persecution which had started in AD 65 after Nero had burned the city of Rome for 10 days, and later on he had to blame the Christians for his atrocities. Then they were burnt and some were clothed in animal skins, so that when darkness fell, they became like torches in Rome, the Christians, because of their faith. So when John is writing this book, he is writing this book to rekindle the hope and the faith of those who are under persecution.
Amen.
So
Amen.
This book is for us even to
Amen.
This day.
Amen.
When he wrote this book, the church was beginning to wonder, if this person dies, because when John, the church boards of those days, I think they were a bit nice, because John would simply say, ladies and gentlemen, when this thing happened, when Jesus was still around, on planet Earth, when we went to Peter's house, to his mother-in-law's house, what did he do? He said this. When we were at the Mount of Transfiguration, this is what he said. So the church was of those moments, of those days, were a little bit better, because John was around. We had a physical experience with Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So now, as he was about to die, he was a bit old. No wonder when he's writing, he says, I write to you, my little children. He was about to die. So the church was a bit worried. What will happen after this person dies to the church? So he wrote this book to proclaim that life continues even after my death. This is how you are going to live even after those who had a physical and literal experience of Jesus have all gone by. Number two. Number three, why did he write the book of John? Why did he write this, this gospel? He wrote this book as a prophylactic, which was a remedy to the Aerosteobacter, which was affecting the church in the form of Gnosticism. Gnosticism was saying Jesus Christ was a human being who was promoted to be a God. So when John is writing, he is writing to defend both the divinity and the humanity of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Are we together, church?
Amen.
Now, let's come to the theme of the book of John. The book of John is a gospel, but it's not amongst the synoptic gospels.
Yeah.
There are those that we call the synoptic gospels. That's Matthew, Mark, and Luke. Why synoptic? The word synoptic would simply mean similar. So it's not similar. Of course, he's foretelling, or he's retelling the life and the experience of Jesus Christ on planet Earth, but in a different way than Mark, Luke, and John. Are we together, church?
Yes.
Or than Matthew, Mark, and Luke. In the synoptics, the difference now, as we are coming to the theme, in the synoptics, when Jesus performed a miracle, he would touch people, the physical touch. Are we together, church? Peter's mother-in-law was sick. Jesus touched her, and she was revived. There was this son of the widow of Nain who had died. And they were going to the graveyard. Jesus touched the coffin, and he was resuscitated. There was this daughter of Jairus, and she was dead. Jesus touched her and said, Talita kumi, and she rose from the dead. In Matthew, Mark, and Luke, Jesus touches people. But in the book of John, Jesus does not touch people altogether. In the book of John, he is not a Jesus who touches, but he is a Jesus who speaks the word.
Amen.
He went to the wedding at Cana, as he was there, while he was no more, completely, finished. And Jesus said, Philip, he was told, there's no more wine here. And he said, fill up the jars. And the miracle happened.
Amen.
He did not touch, but he spoke away.
Amen.
All right.
All right. Amen.
He went to the pool of Bethsaida.
Amen.
There was a man who had an infirmity for 38 years. He said, do you want to be healed?
Yeah.
And he said, I don't have anyone or someone to throw me into the water.
Amen.
And Jesus said, rise up,
amen,
take thy bed and go. He did not touch him.
Amen.
He spoke away.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
The noble woman's son was sick.
Yeah.
And he came to Jesus. And Jesus said, go back home.
Yeah.
Your faith has healed your son.
Amen.
He did not touch him. He spoke a word.
Amen.
A man was blind.
Yeah.
Jesus spat on the ground.
Yeah.
Mixed the man.
Yeah.
What? Go over.
Amen.
Amen. And he said, go now to the river Siloam and wash there. And the miracle happened. He spoke away.
Amen.
Lazarus was dead.
Oh,
yes. He said, show me where you have laid him.
Yeah.
They showed him. He did not touch the grave, but
amen,
he spoke. He shouted, Lazarus, come forth. He did not touch, but he spoke.
Amen.
So John is saying, as we are all going to die,
yeah,
the leaders, the elders, who walked with Jesus, we had a physical experience with him. This is now how we are going to live.
Yeah.
As Jesus is away, his word is just as good as his touch.
Amen.
We do not live through touching or whatever, putting our hands in plastic, but we live by faith.
Amen.
Now faith comes through hearing, and hearing comes through the word of God. This word,
amen,
is just as good as his touch.
Amen.
No wonder when he's introducing the book, he doesn't introduce Jesus as the bread of life.
Yeah.
Though he is the bread of life.
Yeah.
He doesn't introduce Jesus as the resurrection and the life.
Yeah.
Though he is the resurrection and the life.
Yeah.
He doesn't introduce Jesus as the light of the world.
Yeah.
Though he is the light of the world. He is saying, this is the theme of the book.
Yeah.
This is now how we are going to live,
yeah,
throughout the ages.
Yeah.
Up until he comes back. He says, in the beginning was the way.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Now John chapter 10.
Amen. Amen.
John chapter 10.
Amen.
The word is saying.
Amen.
The word is saying. The shepherd and the sheep.
Amen.
That's the topic.
Amen.
Shepherd and the sheep.
Amen.
Point number one, to note. Point to note. The shepherd is the only person who is good.
Okay.
Yeah?
Alright.
Are we together?
Amen.
Jesus says, I am the
good.
That definite article there.
Yeah.
The good shepherd.
Mm.
Meaning there are a lot of shepherds.
Yeah.
He doesn't say, I am a shepherd, I'm a good shepherd.
Yeah.
He is not a good shepherd.
Yeah.
But he is the.
Amen.
If you remove the, then Jesus becomes an ordinary man.
Yes.
He is saying you have a lot of shepherds.
Yes.
Your pastors are your shepherds.
Yeah.
The deacons are your shepherds.
Yeah.
Your parents are your shepherds. Your friends are your shepherds. Your boyfriends might be your shepherds. Your girlfriend might be a shepherdess. But they are not good. I am the one.
Amen.
Who is good?
Yes,
I am the good.
Amen.
Shepherd.
Yes.
Amen.
Point number one.
Mm.
Point number two.
Mm.
The good.
Yeah.
Shepherd.
Mm.
Jehovah Mufuti wangu, wangu, abana, jani, chaiwa,
anoni ratisa pasi, pama kuromba nyoro.
Point number two, what does the good shepherd do? He says,
yes,
I lay down my life for my sheep.
Yes.
Of course, that's the sacrifice of the good shepherd. Jesus dying for the sheep.
Mm-hmm.
The owner dying for the sheep. The possessor dying for the possessed, for the possession. Point number three,
yeah,
how does he know? He says, I know my sheep, and my sheep know me.
Yeah.
I know my sheep, and they know me.
Yeah.
How does he know them?
Yeah.
He says in verse 2 to 3, he says, I know them by name.
Oh,
amen.
Irregardless of the location,
okay,
those that are in USA, he knows them.
Mm.
Those that are in Ghana, he knows them. Those that are in Antigua and Barbuda, those in Poland, those in Germany, those in Russia, those in Ukraine, those in Qatar, those in Bahrain, those in Myanmar, those in Haiti, those in Tahiti, those in Africa, those in Egypt, those in Tanzania, those in Lesotho, those in Swaziland, those in Botswana, those in Mozambique, those in South Africa, even those in Zimbabwe, he knows them by name.
Yeah. Yeah.
Where in Zimbabwe? Gutu, Manjokonjo, Manjengenja, Maungwa, Chekure, Pampandawana, he knows them. From where? Where? Mukwas, Kwari, Mutautu, he knows them. Those from Zarabani, those from Dotito, those from Jewish, those from Harare, those from Chitungwisa, those from Bocha, Kwamarange, those from Cholocho, those from Lupane, those from Plumtree, those from Bedbridge, even those from Kontu to Siatuna, he knows them by name.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Pumula North, Pumula South.
Yeah.
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 Nasty. And even those at the Polytechnic College, he is saying, I know them one by one by name.
Amen.
Let me submit to the church that there is a Jesus who knows you.
Amen.
Your boyfriend might forget about you.
Amen.
Your father might forget about you.
Amen.
Some of you here, I know, you are crying, weeping before the Lord. Your parents have forgotten about you. Those who promised to sponsor you have disappeared like benzene into the air. But there's Jesus. Many might forget you, but Jesus knows you.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
What is this? I is only a sparrow. And I know you watch it, it's me. I sing because I'm happy. I sing because I'm free. His eye is on the sparrow. And I know you watch it. They employed and the employable. The unemployed and the unemployable.
Okay.
He knows them.
Amen.
They used.
Yeah.
Reused.
Yeah.
Refused.
Yeah.
Those who think they've become refuse.
Ah, yeah.
Rejected.
Yeah.
Rejected.
Yeah.
Dejected.
Yeah.
He knows them.
Amen.
By name.
Yeah.
The sick and the fit.
Yeah.
He knows them.
Amen.
By name.
Amen.
Those that have failed and those that have made it in the exam, he knows them.
Amen.
By name.
Amen.
Wherever you are, there is a God who knows.
Amen.
You.
Amen.
Sure.
Amen.
Sure.
Amen.
The shepherd.
Hallelujah.
And the sheep. I love this part. It's nice now, Pastor Brian.
Yeah.
As he's driving them out,
amen.
He sings. He leads them.
I want to get the church.
Amen.
There's a certain song in Shona that I love so much. He leads the sheep.
Yeah.
The sheep who never lead the shepherd.
Right. Right.
But the shepherd leads the sheep.
Yeah.
Why and how?
Okay.
Why the sheep are led? Because they are the sheep. Their duty is to follow, not to lead. Why?
Yeah.
Point number two, how do they follow him? They listen to his voice.
Yeah.
They know his voice.
Yeah.
They do not know his appearance.
Yeah.
Their appearance might be a little bit deceived.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
We can have the same beard.
Yeah.
The same suit.
Yeah.
Same jackets in a.
Yeah.
Same voice.
Yeah.
I mean. But looks might deceive.
Oh.
So the shepherd, the sheep say, "I would rather listen to the voice." Yes. That is what we know. Mm. We will not follow the physical appearance, but we'll follow the voice.
Yeah.
Mm. Elite.
Yeah.
And they follow.
Iwe wakaneta uya kuna Yesu baka kufira iwe po chijiko uchaisha na kuwa na hai kuma Yesu
tuna mire
zara
narura moyo wako yungu wegana katuwa
sirunya
uchaisha ya kuwa ya kara
sickness, allow Jesus to lead. Let Jesus lead. In prosperity, let him lead. As you are studying for your final exams, let him lead. As things are not happening the way you like, let him lead. Rejected.
And dejected.
Dejected.
Yeah.
Let him lead. You have a strong financial instability.
Yeah.
You are financially crippled.
Yeah.
Let him lead.
Amen.
Physical disability or challenge.
Yeah.
Let him lead.
Amen.
You have lost a loved one. Never ever go before Jesus. Always following. There was a game that we used to play when we were still in primary school. Follow, follow, follow. I follow my lead.
Amen.
Follow Jesus.
Amen.
Wherever he goes.
Amen.
But why are you following him? You are not looking at his appearance. But it's because you know the voice
Amen.
Of the shepherd.
Amen.
The voice of the shepherd.
Amen.
We follow him because this is what we know.
Amen.
Are we together?
Amen.
As he is away, he has already taught us how to manage a long distance relationship.
Amen.
With humans, it's very impossible.
Yes.
Because we want some physical experience to touch, to be touchy touch.
Amen.
So as he is away, don't worry. His word is just as good as his touch. That's managing a long distance relationship.
Amen.
We don't
Amen.
Survive. Or live by seeing like Thomas.
Amen.
We don't survive or live by trusting like Thomas.
Amen.
We don't survive or live by touching like Thomas. We
Amen.
Don't live through a physical experience,
Amen.
But by God's word.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
They know his voice. Amen. If a stranger comes, are we together, Chicha?
Amen.
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 If a stranger comes, come a stranger. One sheep. You are now a sheep. You are going this way, John. So, a stranger comes. They run away because they know. Because they are not running. Going your own way. Calling the sheep. Calling the sheep.
Yeah.
Now they are here in between.
Yeah.
He's calling.
Yeah.
And I'm calling.
Mm.
What do they do?
Yeah.
He's calling. They run away because. They run away because they do not recognize the voice of the stranger. They know the voice of the shepherd. In the world that we are living in today, there are a lot of voices. There's the voice of the shepherd and the voice of the stranger. What are the voice of the shepherd saying concerning the state of the dead? What are the voice of the stranger saying concerning the state of the dead? The voice of the shepherd, what does it say concerning the Sabbath? The voice of the stranger, what does it say concerning the Sabbath? The voice of Jesus, what does it say concerning the spiritual prophet? The voice of the stranger, what does it say concerning the spiritual prophet? If there is something which is contrary to the voice
Amen.
Of the shepherd,
Amen.
The sheep run away because
Amen.
They know this thing.
Amen.
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 How do they know? Today, how can we know the voice of the shepherd?
Amen.
Right? Read John 8, verse 8 to 9.
Yeah.
How can we know the voice? How can the sheep know the voice
John 8.
Of the shepherd? Listen to this one.
Verse 8 to 9.
Verse 8 to 9.
Amen.
And he,
and again,
there is something that I was an expert in. Okay. When I was still in primary school,
yeah.
I used to get two things right.
Yeah.
The first one were the examples of the teacher.
Yeah.
The second one was dismissed.
Yeah.
So I love examples and dismiss.
Yeah.
Now, come right.
And again. He stooped down. And wrote on the ground.
What did he do, church?
He
wrote Jesus' writing.
Yeah.
Wrote on the ground.
Then those who hate it.
Hey. Come again, Foots. Start reading.
Now move with me, church.
Amen.
And again, he stooped down.
He stooped it down.
Yes, sir. And wrote on the ground.
Wrote on the ground.
Then those.
Then those
who hate it.
When I was in grade 2D, teacher Manuano was my teacher.
Yeah.
You would write or put some charts on the board.
Yeah.
And you would say, what can you see?
Okay.
I can see M. Zero, one. Writing on the board. One, two, what can you see? I can see one, I can see two. Written. That which is written. Is supposed to be seen.
Mm-hmm.
Are we dead?
Yes.
But when Jesus
wrote,
they did not see, but they heard. Are we together? The relationship of the shepherd and the sheep is based upon two instruments.
Okay.
From the shepherd comes the voice.
Yeah.
From the sheep, there is the ear which hears the voice.
Amen.
Jesus wrote. And they heard. The Bible is not supposed to be seen.
Okay.
It is supposed to be heard. Read and hear.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. This book.
Yeah.
This book is electronic.
Okay.
It is an audio visual Bible.
Yeah.
It is written. But you hear what is written.
Yeah.
You don't see.
Yeah.
It is different. From telling in this, why does the guy, the falcon cannot hear the falcon.
Yeah.
Things fall apart, the center cannot hold.
Yeah.
Things fall apart, you read, but the Bible you hear. Are we together, Church of God? It is different from it is the whiteness of teeth that makes us laugh in this world.
Yeah.
The Bible, what we take, that one we see, we don't hear. It is different from us, the Neo-Normland. It is different from Patrick Chakaipa's books.
Yeah.
Those we see, but the Bible we hear. It is different from 12th Night by William Shakespeare. That we see, but the Bible we hear. This book is different from Thomas Hart, the mayor of Casterbridge.
Yeah.
That we see, but the Bible we hear what it is. Different from book, what you want. I will marry when I want. The trial of the Daniel, the river between those with is different from postage, it's different from Sandra Brown's books. Those books we see, but the Bible we hear what it is.
Amen.
I wonder why in Revelation, in the letters to the seven churches, John will simply say, let him who is an evil hear what the Spirit says.
Amen. Amen.
So what is written is yet.
Amen.
Do you hear what is written in this book?
Amen.
You wonder why?
Thank you.
Ethiopian eunuch.
Amen.
He was traveling from Jerusalem.
Amen.
He was traveling from Jerusalem.
Mm-hmm.
See my, follow me across the church.
Okay.
There's a certain statement. I love you because I'm not running from getting eunuch.
Amen.
Amen. Say that again, please.
Amen.
Mm. Mother, never forget. Don't give a dick.
Hallelujah.
The Ethiopian eunuch in his chariot is coming from Jerusalem, from the Pentecost experience. Thank you so much, Ethiopian eunuch. He's traveling home, reading Isaiah.
He's
reading Isaiah. Then the Lord says, he's passive. He's reading. But Thomas comes, and the Spirit becomes human and says, my brother, do you hear what you are reading?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
There is no one to explain these things for me.
Yeah.
Do you hear?
Yeah. Amen.
What is written in here is different from the introduction, the body, the conclusion, the literature view, and the bibliography.
Found
in a book.
Amen.
Those things you see.
Amen.
But what is written in here is supposed to be heard.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Now my last verse, pray. As the shepherd was reading there, he said, I'm left with 15 minutes now. I'm about to finish, I'll finish in 15 minutes. As the shepherd is leading them, he leads them the fold. He leads them to the pastures. That's where we were. There's someone who once read, was it Psalms 23 in the morning?
Amen.
Well, this was a song, I don't know now, I forgot it.
Amen.
But I heard something about Psalms 23. It says, the Lord is my shepherd. Is it true?
Amen.
Read one and two. There is something that I love in Psalms chapter 23, verse 1 and 2. Just read that one. It's our last verse.
Amen.
Psalm 23.
Verse 1 and 2.
Verse 1 and 2.
He leads them.
Yes. Now the Lord is
the Lord.
My shepherd.
He's my shepherd.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
I shall not want.
He wants me. I shall not want.
Amen.
He makes me to lie down in green pastures.
Thank you. Amen. Sit down.
Amen.
Yeah. Thank you for this word. Yeah. He makes me to lie down in pastures.
Amen.
That's it. That's something that is beautiful. He leads them.
Yeah.
Wherever he's going to lead his sheep, we know that the pastures are always green. How to get? Because the shepherd's the one who is leading.
Amen.
He will always lead his sheep to pastures green. How to get there?
Amen.
He has led them to pastures green now. He has led them. Now we decide. But this sheep will never move. They will never make any movement until they hear the shepherd's voice. How to get? So he decides to lead them here. They'll stick to this place up until the shepherd calls them to shift positions.
Right.
Are we together?
Yeah.
Up until they hear the master's call, calling them to change positions.
Okay.
So he leaves them here.
Yeah.
He may decide to go wherever he wants, to town, to Harare, wherever, but they will remain rooted here, waiting for the master's voice, instructing them to change positions. Are we together, church?
Amen.
Jesus, 1831, he ascended to heaven.
Amen.
Are we together, church?
Hallelujah.
He ascended
Amen.
To heaven.
Amen.
The state
Amen.
In which he left this church in
okay.
is the state you want to see this church in when it comes again.
Amen. Yes. Amen.
If you change positions,
he
left a worshiping church, a Sabbath keeping church, a church baptizing in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Once, deep, immersing once in water, how to get that means you come back to the original position where he left his sheep in. But still, in the pastures, some sheep, the shepherd maybe is trying to sort out some things, right? Some, because they are green, some may tire and decide to rest. So they lie down. No, you are not lying down. I'm the one who's lying down.
So they lie down.
They lie down.
Yeah.
How would you get?
Amen.
They lie down in the pastures.
Yeah.
There are others which are standing.
Yeah.
Others are lying down.
Yeah.
The sheep that are lying down, that are tired, and those that are standing.
Yeah.
Both these two groups,
yeah.
they are waiting for the master's call.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah. Those that are standing
yes.
and those that are lying down,
yes.
they have a blessed hope
yes.
of the soon appearance of the shepherd
yes.
to call them home,
yes,
to proclaim
yeah.
darkness has fallen.
Yeah.
Evening has come.
Yes.
This pastor is no longer good for you.
Yeah.
Let me take you home. I was preparing something for you.
Yes.
They are waiting for the master's voice.
Yeah.
Those lying down and those that are standing.
Mm-hmm.
It will never happen by accident. That those that are standing might decide to go home before the master calls.
Yeah.
Those that are lying down will never go home without those that are standing.
Yeah.
And those that are standing will never go home without those that are lying. Because these two groups are waiting for the master's call.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Yeah.
Those that are lying are lying in pastures.
Yeah.
How to get?
Yes.
Yeah. Pleasant it is in the sight of the Lord.
Yeah.
The death of his love. That one is a pleasure in the sight of God.
Yeah.
If he said it dies.
Amen. Amen.
Now Paul says,
yeah.
for me to live.
Amen.
Christ. But to die. In the pastures.
Amen.
To die.
Amen.
I will not be resting
Amen.
In the cold soil. To a Christian does not rest in the cold soil.
Amen.
But a Christian rests in the pastures. And he's waiting
Amen.
for the soon appearance of the Master.
Amen.
Amen.
So when the Master calls,
yeah.
The Master calls.
Yeah.
When the Master calls,
yeah.
When he calls,
amen.
What does he do?
Yeah.
You know.
Amen.
You know. I tell you a mystery. Before we go to the mystery,
yes.
First Thessalonians, what does it say?
Amen.
For the Lord himself shall descend. With the what? With the shout and with the voice. Why voice? Is it because the sheep trained themselves to listen to the voice of the Master?
Amen.
Jesus will never come to touch the grave.
Amen.
You will use the voice.
Amen.
That's the instrument that is going to, the last instrument that is going to use to resurrect the dead long time. Why? Because when the sheep slept, their ears were in tune to hear the voice of the Master.
Amen.
They may think I'm John chapter 5, verse 29.
Amen.
Verse 29.
Amen. Amen.
Do not marvel.
Amen.
Do not marvel at this, for the hour is coming.
Amen.
Yes,
in which all who are in the grave,
well, those who are lying in
the
pasture, they will hear his voice.
Amen.
When he comes again, Jesus will never touch this
girl. Amen.
His feet will never rest on this
girl. Amen.
You think John 14, verse 1, people will say, Jesus said, I will come to take you. He never said, I will come to take you.
Yeah.
Correct that verse by reading it.
Yeah.
So that they need.
Yeah.
He never said, I will come to take you.
Yeah.
You
yeah.
Those who are waiting to be taken by Jesus, you are lost.
Amen.
When you buy your Bible,
amen.
You need to pray. You will never take people home. But what is he coming to do? Yes.
Amen.
John
14,
verse 1.
Far from. Let not your heart be troubled.
Amen.
You believe in me.
God.
Yes.
Believe also in me.
Papa.
For in my father's
house,
I'm not in mansion.
Papa.
It were not so.
Yes,
I would have told you so.
Yes.
I go to prepare a place for you.
When I go
and prepare a place for you,
I will come again
and receive you.
Amen.
Why is it? It's because these sheep are used to the Master's voice.
Amen.
So if he goes from this direction,
yeah.
They will come.
Yeah.
You will receive them.
Yeah.
How to get them?
Amen.
He's not coming to take us.
Amen.
But you will go.
Amen.
You reach a certain stage.
Amen.
Certain level.
Amen.
And he will call.
Amen.
And his sheep, because they are used to hear his voice, they will wake up from the graves to be received by the Master.
Praise the Lord.
Now we want to pray.
Amen.
People have dedicated their houses,
amen.
Dedicated their bicycles.
Hallelujah.
They don't know that Jesus is interested in the ear.
Amen.
Okay. People go to school, they pray for the kids. Pray for everything. They dedicate their degrees, dedicate their home, dedicate their wives, everything.
Amen.
Why don't you dedicate your ear to hear the Master's voice?
Amen.
What to pray with those who say, Christ. Of course, I've been dedicated to this church,
yeah.
But today I want to dedicate my ear to hear your voice so that we establish a relationship now. So that when you come, I will hear your last call.
Mm-hmm.
Who wants to hear the voice of the Lord? Say, now, Father, I want to dedicate my ear into your hands. May you stand as we are about to pray.
Now, as we pray, you ought to understand this one thing, that when people have heard the voice of God, he continues to say, when you hear his word, do not do what? Do not harden your heart.
Amen.
But you know what? There is one thing I've learned ever since I preached on this ground, that each time you make a call, never forget to extend it to an individual who might decide to choose Christ as his Lord and personal Savior for the first time.
Amen.
Then adventure, it happens that there is a sheep that had fallen astray and followed a stranger. In following the stranger, there is no life. There are no green pastures. You lie down, but not in green pastures. Why? Because those who went with the stranger, where they are lying, the pastures are not green. Why? Because when the Master comes and he calls by name, they will not be able to hear the voice. So I need to make a call just for one individual before the pastor prays for us. One person who is saying, Father, I need to say, I'm not only dedicating my name, I'm not only dedicating my ear, but I'm making this extended step or taking a step further. I choose you as my Lord and personal Savior, so that when you walk as the shepherd, I will be able to follow you. Is there anybody who is saying, Father, I made that decision this day to choose you as my Lord and personal Savior? If you are there, why don't you raise your hand wherever you are? Just
Just raise your hand. We want to pray together, and the prayer is going to be simple. Pastor Slana, be stepping forward to pray for us. We just want to pray for you to say, you know what? This decision you would have made is the greatest and the best decision ever. I'm not saying there is somebody more, but the only thing I'm saying is, peradventure there is someone who needs to be given that opportunity. You have heard the voice of the shepherd. Now be an obedient sheep and take the stand. Is there anybody who is saying, Father, I choose you today as my Lord and personal Savior? The pastor is going to pray for us. The pastor is going to pray for us. Is there anyone who wants to make that decision? God bless you as the pastor prays for us.
Our heads are bowed, our eyes are closed. Father God in heaven, we want to thank you for this beautiful design that you have made in us. Thank you for the gift of hearing. And thank you for enabling us to understand that this hearing sense is the last sense to go before we die. And it will be the very first sense to revive when you receive us. Father, we commit ourselves before your glorious throne. Our hearts are filled with burdens of different kind. We want to call upon your name this morning and say, may you receive us, dear Lord. We have journeyed into different directions, and some of us might have moved away from the pastures green where you ordered us to stay. And in case there be any who has wandered away, we pray that you may reclaim us and draw us nearer to thee. In this morning, we commit ourselves unto you. Some of us had made this decision a long time ago, but want to reaffirm it. May you sharpen our sense of hearing. There are so many bound-beckoning voices out there, and the devil is calling equally just as your spirit calls us. And at some time, he is giving us things that are more cunning to the sight, so much that the sight is more drawing us than the hearing sight is. Father, we pray that you be with us in all that we hear. May you sober our reactions. We commit ourselves in this situation and environment we are in. We have friends within and without. And at this moment, at this period, when exams are running, some of us have been made to see and test what failure is. And we pray, Father, that you may not make us tails but heads. May you lead us. These complications and challenges that are facing us are causing us to be dispirited. May you not allow the devil to make use of us. May you keep us within the fold so that none of us moves away from the fold. Teach us to follow after you. Wherever you lead us, we are going to follow you. If you decide to lead us through failure, don't just do that without assuring a second chance. Father, we are going to go different directions, but we pray that we hold on to your hand and cause in us courage that will make us firm until we break that eastern sky. Thank you for the word that has come to us. Thank you for your man servant, Pastor Munyara Tsalan. Indeed, he has comforted the souls. May your Holy Spirit continue to comfort us and to lead us to the pastures green. Thank you for the service that we've just had, and thank you for the friends and family of believers amongst us. Usher us and dismiss us with the richest blessing from afar. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Amen.